and I feel Indians have a natural inclination towards entrepreneurship. I'm Manju Bharatram. I'm a social entrepreneur. I wanted to set up an educational institution because our family has been in education, and I felt that school education was an area where there was a huge gap, especially in Delhi. We had lived in Madras, and my children went to a school where they enjoyed going each day. It was never a problem. And when we shifted to Delhi, back to Delhi, I did see that was happening with my children. And that's when I decided that, yes, we have to also get into education and make a difference. Because to me, education is learning about learning, but in a happy environment and enjoy learning. Teaching is a skilled profession. It's not everyone's cup of tea. And you have to have an aptitude to be able to teach, because to come down to the level of a child is something very few people can do. Also, there are other skills required, like classroom management and discipline, being able to identify children who have problems of disability, whether it's attention disorder or hyperactive syndrome and things like that. There's so many problems that we, running a school, we see in children, which very few of the our normal teachers are able to identify. And I personally feel a lot of the dropouts that we hear of are those cases where the teacher just doesn't know anything about it. Our whole teacher curriculum is so poor. It was designed sometimes in 1892, which we are still following. There are total about 1,000 teaching institutes in India. And that also, you know, you can take only 30 to 40 students at one time to be able to teach. The new curriculum that has been formed is a person has to spend 4 years before they can get the degree. Even in the Right to Education Act, they have stipulated minimum qualifications. And I have seen, you know, the person may have all the requisite degrees, but when it comes to, you know, asking the person, I mean, this is during the interview process, I've seen that they're not able to explain a concept and all. In this context, a teacher, apart from imparting education, is also a counselor, is a nurturer. There's so many aspects to being a teacher.
A business sense also, and in my case, I have no idea of finance and all and fortune, but I know I'm good at organizing and I am good at visioning, and I have an instinct towards certain things which helps an entrepreneur. And fortunately, what is lacking in me, my husband provided. And I've learned a lot while getting into social entrepreneurship. There was a drive within me which I felt that I'm sure I can do something. And I feel Indians have a natural inclination towards entrepreneurship. Over this 20 years period of the school being set up, I've seen the children who were considered dropouts and failures in life are doing so well because we took them in our school and found out what they were good in and encouraged that, be it art, be it singing, be it sports, be it anything, you know. So I was convinced that education is not what makes an entrepreneur, it's the drive within you and your vision. For various calamities that have taken place, natural disasters in the country, our children have reached out. And that is not only creating an entrepreneurial spirit in them, is also, you know, developing a social sense in them. We are giving them a sense of business. See, we've got a vending machine, the coffee vending machine. The teachers take them to the market, make them do the transaction, you know, all them financial transaction, and even cut out cash memos, little things. And the sense of pride the child gets that they are able to do it, it's a great experience. Politicians are also not interested in the people getting educated, because if they did, then people would vote, you know, whom they think who has delivered. The country is progressing because of the social entrepreneurs that there are. So everyone can't be a social entrepreneur because I know there are people who only think of business and making money. Profiteering is the idea. But social entrepreneurship, that is not there. And that was one thing also lacking in me. I had started a business, but it was a huge failure. Unless the leader or the promoter has it in him to be doing it, they can't do it. If you have decided to do something, do it. It can be done, and it will give you a great high in your own. You'll have respect in your own eyes for yourself.